When conducting an experiment, you encounter experimental error and random fluctuations that are unavoidable. So how do you determine if the observed differences in your result variable are due to the actual factor you are investigating or just by chance? The answer is you perform an ANOVA. Hey, my name is Marcel. I have a PhD in chemical engineering, and this video is a very basic introduction to what ANOVA is. No statistics, no complicated formulas, just the basics. And we start with the concept of significant parameters. In any experiment, it's crucial to identify which factors significantly impact your results. These significant parameters are the factors that cause real changes in your response variable beyond what might happen due to random chance. ANOVA helps us to pinpoint these parameters by analyzing the variation within our data. Doing that allows you to save time and resources in the lab, but also to understand the system that you're studying better, because you can exclude these insignificant parameters from your further experiments and you're not chasing randomness in your experimental results. But what exactly is ANOVA doing? ANOVA breaks down the total variation in your data into two parts: between group variation and within group variation. Random variation or experimental error is the within group variation, while variation that arises due to the factors you're testing is the between group variation. By comparing the between group variation and the within group variation, ANOVA determines whether the factors that you're studying are actually significant or actually have a significant effect on your response variable, or if these fluctuations that you observe are just by chance. And in practice, that usually works through comparing the p-values. The p-value in ANOVA shows how likely it is that the differences we observe within our data are due to chance. If the p-value is low, usually less than 0.05, it means that the differences are likely real with a 5% chance of being wrong. Or in other words, if the p-value is smaller than 0.05, we look at a significant parameter. Let me know in the comments below if you would be interested in a more detailed video about how to perform ANOVA with Python. And don't forget to like and subscribe to the channel.